The assembled East Wake JV seems destined for a bright future. But when the freshman loaded football force stood with an entire career in front of it, the premiere was here. So, go time. Right against the Golden Demons for a golden demonstration. A majority of touted rookies experienced their first high school contact. With varsity coordinators watching, of course, the opening defensive series fell right into place. No thankies to the Hankies, because a flag flew once an average of every three plays all night long. Yet the Warriors hailed, then hailed four taxis before losing a grip on a bad punt snap. Fike recovered at the East Wake 30. Eight plays later, a 4th and 10 placed it in for 6. The PAT padded a 7-0 gets gust. Another fumble on the very next offensive play put the Demons on the Warrior 36. Seven plays down the gridiron, Fike turned the corner and raised the margin to 13-0. The Warriors rallied with 12 hikes, 3 first downs, some Jaden Goodson yards, an Earl Richardson dive, a Josiah Osborne orchestrated drive, and 1 humongous foul. Not only did the ref interfere with this catch frame, but he also blocked the TD, citing an ineligible receiver downfield. East Wake did get the ball back with less than a minute left in the half, where persistence paid off. Ta-da! Osborne found Derek Lyles behind the secondary on a 20-yard TD with 28 seconds left before intermission. Michael Vick spruced the speedy deuce. It was 13-8 at the half. Lights, camera, nucleus, reaction. Yes, the youngsters took their growing pains. Yes, but also inflicted some. Earl Richardson's low punt, haul in, and haul off quickly switched field position and swung momentum. Cue a three-play explosion, featuring this final exploit. A Goodson scoop through a chute, cannonballing him 38 yards to the go-ahead score. Osborne's zing to Torrey Holland added the extra sauce. It was 16-13. Sacks, stacks, and nothing slings exercise the demon possession. The close contest caused some chippiness down the line. Out came the caution flag. Osborne kept, then swiveled and delivered to Vic, who weaved past traffic to merge with the deep red zone.
Oh, that's it!
Where Mike Ingles reached pay dirt despite a fender bender. No two, but the Warriors were too far in front at 22-13 to be caught. Fike unloaded some anger though. Then the trespassers pose some more danger. Its invasion advanced against repeat reminders. An escape act plus a rope trick reduced the margin to 22-19. That was all due to a blue and gold wall. The Warriors staff resorted to sideline chess moves, preparing for the anticipated onside kick. But Fike preferred to bottle up and battle on in order to retrieve the rock again. When it did, these possible big gains eluded its grasp. However, a screen did not avoid Anthony Brown. The Warrior lineman hooked the hurl and installed the insurance at the house. Osborne bored across the pair, putting the capper on a 30-19 conquer. That deficit could have been worse, since Goodson picked off a pick-me pass and rumbled 74 yards. A clipping call canceled the celebration. Oh, that was cheering all right. Just not about the Warrior Path wipeout. The Demons, though, were dead and buried here. Because resurrection was simply beyond their reach. This is Don Fuller, East Wake Television.